Om Jnanati Miram Asyat Jnanam Jana Shalaka Chakshur Nilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guru.
I know it doesn't set a very good example, but I think yesterday a devotee was narrating to me about one Babaji who fell in Radha Kund and stayed there in ecstasy. So this was presumed to be a great manifestation of Krishna Prema. Our acharyas, our great acharyas, we don't hear so much stories like this about them. The kind of stories we mostly hear from Sahajiya, etc.
Oh.
Those who are real devotees, they're interested in serving the mission of the Lord. Oh. And this way we see that Sankirtan devotees are very active. You won't find them sitting around talking about praying very much. They're more interested in practically serving the mission of the Lord. Talk of praying is cheap. Anyone can say praying, right? But the actual, what is the basis of praying is the tibra bhakti, the very strong desire to, or the focused desire to serve. So, Sankirtan devotees, they're not very much interested in falling into trances or fainting in ecstasy. They're interested in putting their books in their bag and getting out and distributing them. That is their ecstasy. And Srila Prabhupada said, my purports are my devotional ecstasy. Prabhupada's writing these books, that was his expression of his ecstasy about Krishna. It was his service to the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And his disciples, they partake in Prabhupada's ecstasy. They receive the blessings of Prabhupada's ecstasy by distributing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted his name spread to every town and village in the world. So, if we all don't sit in Radha Kund, how will that happen? Therefore, Prabhupada, he didn't give much credence to, not only Prabhupada, but not to Sankirtan Sahasrara. He didn't give much credence to devotees who just sit and do their own Raja, even if they're
credence
means much
favor.
God, credence means authorization. Sit in Radha Kund, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that he wants his name preached all over the world. Who's going to do that? That is real service. They were actually very fortunate to have this opportunity to engage in the Sankirtan mission. There's a well-known anecdote of two of Prabhupada's sannyasis. They went for darshan at Radharaman temple in Vrindavan, and they were taking darshan with great awe, great regard. And seeing this, the pujari in the temple was so impressed that he said that, oh, you have such devotion for Radharaman. I bless you that in your next life you may be born in India, and you can also worship Radharaman. The sannyasis, they went back to Krishna Balaram, which was still under construction, and told this one of the magician. Prabhupada said, you should go back and offer him the blessing, offer that pujari the blessing, that in your next life you may be born in the Western countries, so that you may have the opportunity to preach Krishna consciousness all over the world. You take him part in preaching Krishna consciousness all over the world. There are many Babajis in Radha Kund, about half of them are Russian. They didn't give us a good opportunity there. Actually, when the Western devotees first came, the Babajis there said that, Westerners can't be devotees. Now they're very anxious to be the Babaji initiation. So, anyway, Sankirtan devotees, they're very practical. They know what is the essence of devotional service. Pleasing Krishna to the form of Prabhupada. They're not engaged in imaginative Krishna consciousness, imagining themselves to the gopis. Engaged in a very practical method of giving knowledge of Krishna to others by distributing Shri. So, he's gone with the Sankirtan mission. It made Russia and the CIS number one in book distribution every year.
Bravo!
So, but. Make Russia and CIS number one in book distribution every year, we will take more than saying Hari Bol and traffic. It will require a lot of hard work. You can do it. Why not? It's a very big country and a lot of devotees. And there's no gross persecution. You can go on legally doing it. People, they're taking the books. They're more or less open to taking the books. It's not very easy, but people do take it. It is different in different countries. It's not favorable to people. It's like devotees in Slovenia were telling me that when they go from Slovenia to Italy, Slovenian devotees, even though they don't speak Italian, they can do four times more books in Italy than in Slovenia. So some places are more favorable than others, and in Russia, at least, field is pretty good to spread information. And people become devotees by reading these books. That's also an encouraging factor, which in some countries is actually very difficult because people are very sophisticated. Especially, my own experience is in Thailand so far, it's been very difficult in Japan. In Japan, I think lots of books are true. It's difficult to make devotees, maybe because of this overriding impersonalism that comes in through Buddhism. In Sweden also, even though many books have been distributed, not many people become devotees, probably because it is also very, very impersonal. The people are colder than the weather. But in Russia, as Primavati told me when I first came here in 1986, the Russian people are hearty people. People may be translated warm-hearted, emotional, good candidates for being devotees of Krishna. So the result of distributing this is very encouraging.
That is
it. The result, you'll see the result of distributing these books, the people become devotees. That's encouraging. So Russia should be number one. All parties to Russia.
Evil!
Russia is the greatest nation on earth. Or will be if you make it simple and normal. This is the right spirit of nationalism. Prabhupada often used to preach like that. Most of the time you preach, you're not the body. You're not Russian, you're not Chinese, you're not American. You are cats and dogs. You're not American cats and dogs. But sometimes you would preach like this. You would say that America, America is leading the world, everyone is looking to America, so make Krishna America, Krishna countries, and the whole world will fall. In England, he said he met one lord. You know these lords, the famous British lord, the porridge, the porridge. In Russia, there's considered the porridge.
Yeah.
So he met one of these lords, and he said to him that actually it was a very great achievement that the British, they had an empire that covered the whole world. Now you are again relegated to being just an insignificant island of course of Europe. But you can again rule the world. You just take a little advice from me. So in this way, Prabhupada appealed to the national sentiment. So Russia is also a great country, and during the earlier phases of the communist times, it was considered an historical inevitability that communism would spread from Russia all over the world. Khrushchev, he told the United Nations, he told that history is on our side. There's no question. Communism is going to take over the world. Well, it didn't happen. Instead of the high ideals of brotherly unity of communism taking over the world, instead, McDonald's, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola, and Madonna, and all these kind of things taking over. So it's time for a new Russian revolution. Revolution of consciousness. Christian consciousness. So make Russia number one in book distribution. That's what I say everywhere. When I'm in India, I say, make India number one. I'm an agent. Actually, I'm an agent of Krishna. But that competition, that also gives some more rasa. It's not materialistic competition. They're competing for the pleasure of Prabhupada. Devotees are, they're asking why I should speak about the qualities of Sankirtan devotees. So Sankirtan devotees are full of lust and greed. To be successful in Sankirtan, you should become more lusty and more greedy. You should be very lusty and very greedy to distribute more books. So, to make Russia number one, it's not just one or two individuals that are going to do it. It requires many devotees coming together. So, in this regard, the role of the leaders is very important. To look after the devotees, Sankirtan, to look after the devotees, especially those devotees who have got that spirit that, yes, we want to go out in the street. So you have a strong group here in Moscow, and coming together, living together, doing Sankirtan together, you help to nourish each other's enthusiasm, help each other to be strong.
Вместе и поддерживая друг друга.
But there are many devotees throughout this part in this group, of course, and also dedicated to institution. They are precious souls, especially Sankirtan minister, in contact with them, keep confusing them, especially those temple presidents, regional secretaries who have got this spirit that we want to distribute these books. Keep in regular contact with them, encourage them, make sure they get their books, whatever books they need on time. And those who are not so much into book distribution, keep on following them up to, hey, how many books are you going to take for the marathon? Not preaching to them, not to take more books. Yeah. Now when you preach now in summertime, you have a great opportunity to do more books. Especially at these big festivals, they're great opportunities in the holiday places. They go to book distribution, people go to the back seat, the holiday. I saw along the boulder also people, they go there, all along the river, they go there, just like the sea, so it's like holiday resort, to find so many people, it's a good opportunity, so many people together. So look out to the Sankirtan devotees, I'm encouraging them. They're attacking Maya, so Maya may attack them more. The Sankirtan devotees also have to look out to themselves, be themselves strong, spiritually, by always chanting, rounds, standing vulnerable, ending the program. Look after the devotees means physically also, see their health. And, of course, there's a lot of talk about caring about Vaishnavas. Sometimes I think that this caring about Vaishnavas, sometimes it almost seems a little mundane when you take it so far. But it's a fact that we have to, devotees who are dedicated their lives for the service, we have to see their physical needs. It's not the main function of our society. We all come together to look after our physical needs. The main function of our society is to look after our spiritual needs. And physical needs also that should be taken care of. Again, it's not that we make it possible. But devotees should be practical also. This distributing books is mostly a physical activity. You actually physically pick the books up, take them out, and bring them to other people. So that is an activity which we should understand that is not done properly. It's on the activity of carrying heavy weights over a long period. It's only very damaging to the body. So we should learn how to lift weights, like boxes of books, in a manner that we don't strain our back. You all know this? You don't bend down to pick it up. You touch down, grab the box, and then stand up. And then if it's not healthy, it's not good also to wear. Have a book bag, heavy weight on one side, then the whole back gets out of shape. So it's better to have books in a stroller, thing you put along, or on your back, rucksack. Or to keep boxes of books. You're distributed on the street, you have boxes of books next to you, and just carry some in your hand. And then eat healthy. In Russia, people don't have much idea about eating healthy. And there is a very, very high rate of cancer and other diseases. So lots of white sugar, white flour, something like that. In the long term, deleterious. So, of course, even keeping the body healthy can be as healthy as an Olympic gold medalist. But that in itself won't have a sister book. That comes from spiritual. And as I was saying, this book distribution is actually Bhakti Yoga. It's linking up with Krishna. But we have to have inspiration from Krishna as we have up with Krishna. And with each individual exchange, people, we have to be linked up with Krishna. We have to represent Krishna. To be linked up with Krishna and represent Krishna. When we're linked with Krishna, then Krishna Shakti flows through us. This Krishna Shakti, this potency of Krishna, overwhelms the Maya Shakti by which they can say no. When the higher Shakti overcomes the lower Shakti, then they will say yes. Sometimes the devotees they ask for, show me how to distribute books. What's the technique? The real technique is to make shelter. Therefore, a book distribution is a great sadhana. It is a better sadhana than sitting in Radhanapur because we directly have an age. Every person we come in contact with, everyone has their own individual combination of nonsense ideas. So we have to pray for inspiration from Krishna to say just that thing which will affect their conscience, which will inspire them to people. Often people who take up their strives to what he says just touches that thing in their heart, which just touches that particular point which means something. The devotee himself may not be exactly aware of what's going on in that person's heart, but Krishna gives the inspiration to him to say that which will affect that person. But a devotee is really absorbed in book distribution, he doesn't even know what's going on himself because he's not really aware of what he's doing. He just flows naturally. He's just a puppet in the hands of the internal potency. He just flows from person to person and his ecstasy just flows over different people. And they take over. All of you have had very good days. When you have a good day in Krishna consciousness, just like you're floating. And those good days when you distribute many books, it's always because you're in good consciousness. No one ever has a good day distributing many books if they're in a bad mood, they're not feeling very Krishna conscious, they haven't chanted their rounds very nicely. Right? Isn't it? It just doesn't happen. If you go out in bad consciousness, book distribution just doesn't happen. You say, well, the commies are in a bad mood today. They're really in Maya. They're really demons today. But actually, it's you who's in a bad mood. And, it's us who are in Maya. It's us who are more like the as a matter of fact, the book description depends on our consciousness. When Krishna reciprocates with our pure desire and our pure consciousness. And it's not mechanical. Sometimes we think our child rounds nicely, I've studied nicely, I'm in very good consciousness there, and then I'm great day. If I go out very confident and the first person comes to help, and the second person comes to help. The third person doesn't say no, he doesn't even look at us. What happened? You know, chanting around nicely, I was going to have a great day. And then we have to realize that we're completely dependent on Krishna. We think we chanted our rounds very nicely, but how much we actually calling out from the depths of our hearts. So if there's any kind of desire that I will show others that I'm the best, Krishna will receive. And he will reciprocate by making sure we don't destroy, by not giving us the mercy that we can destroy them. He will reciprocate by not giving us the mercy for which we can destroy them. Krishna wants us to realize that we're simply, or wants us to have consciousness. We are simply the one who is in that consciousness. Krishna blesses him with the ability to destroy them. And one who goes out and destroys books thinking, I'm pretty good. And Krishna blesses him with the mercy of not distributing many books, and then realizes that I am not the one. So that's why I say that books are better sadhana than sitting in Radha. Because going out on books tracks, Krishna is directing us. Without invading in Radha, I couldn't just see the record. Bhakti stands as for Taka. A person never did so. A person sitting on the sprinkled water on his head. He said that actual Radha Kunda bath is possible when one is attained on a spiritual moment. So this, how do we get the inspiration to just drink water? Well, there may be many answers to that. We always have to encourage each other. That element of competition may add some fun or something. But the those who go on distributing books year after year after year, they are able to do so because they have actually developed qualities of utmost Vaishnava. That is, the quality of genuine passion. Generally, we don't recommend very much in the ministry. But if you do, you'll see it is the daily record of suffering, how people are so much suffering, bewildered by that, how foolish they are. How they're spoiling their vulnerable human enterprise from just going out and meeting the Krishna soul. They are big. Every face you see, their life is so pathetic. They're suffering so much. The time of their suffering, they consider intoxication a great pleasure. The pleasure is simply covering over their suffering. So, probably it's not a very clear experience of consciousness. They read proper books to see what is contrast with this. Sublime, superb spiritual knowledge and books by people. They have great faith and practical realizations. Really, the only hope. Devotees have an ideal. They want to see the whole world happy. They don't think that that will be half Krishna conscious and half materialist. And that's all. They want to see everyone engaged in the team of. I just mentioned to Acharya, the so called Vaishnavas, he told me, well, the Sankirtan devotees, they didn't attend. Of course they didn't attend. Sankirtan devotees, why are they taking the trouble to distribute books? Not that we can present this tremendous knowledge. Krishna says, and what does that practice mean? That we go to Vaishnava. So those who are Sankirtan devotees, they're engaged in people, not just watered down, mixed up, pensive, so called Vaishnavas. Next thing, they'll dress deities in shorts, in Levi jeans, because I think it's nice, but the body knows we should do what Krishna thinks. That is, so we want to change the world. We books want to change the world. Not that we just go on with the world as it is at some time. I'm a little Hare Krishna. We have a disrespect. The world is almost something like Krishna, something almost related to Krishna. See, we have a discotheque where it's Krishna conscious. The words are maybe almost something half related to Krishna. And we go on with life, you see, it's normal. Get married, get divorced. And homosexuality is okay. You have to be realistic. And, sometimes, they're not distributing the books to me. Slightly Krishna-ized material. Krishna-ized change of heart.
Change
of heart. Everything Krishna. Act in a manner that is just only Krishna. These are Krishna seminars are important. And that reinforce our determination to serve Sankara Mission. I suggest and request that next time you make a very big effort to bring devotees all over, Sankara temples all over Russia. Bring Manika, because he's book distribution, ecstasy incoming. For all that, and he was there, sometimes all that, he was very inspired. So he was also very inspired, he was appreciating Russian Vishnu. Number one, that's my message, make Russia number one. Previously, USSR was trying to dominate the world by making more and more atomic bombs. These books are much more powerful than atomic bombs. Bombs simply blow bodies, these book bombs blow people's material attachments to these. The book bombs, they blow the material attachments to them, but definitely you have to make Russia number one.
Yeah.
At the moment, you see there are countries like Czech, Finland, which are, they do lots of books, practically as many or more than Russia. I mean, if you take Czech, they're almost up there, or Finland. The Prague Temple is ahead of Moscow most of the time. If you take, what's the population of Russia? 150 million? What's this population of 145 million? What's the population of Czech? 10 million people. So the Czech temple is always, it's up there. So Czech and Finland, they're some of the leaders all the time. So you should do at least 15 times more books between the Czech and the whole of Russia. Czechoslovakia, only Czech.
But Czech.
Slovakia is something else. That's all I have to say. Now it's up to you.
But I remember in 1992 there was this festival go around the Bajan Band, many Islam leaders, sannyasis, they were themselves participating in this wonderful dancing, which was impressive for all devotees.
That was meant to bring people who are not in devotional service closer to Krishna. That was to introduce Krishna consciousness through their sense qualification. Their motive is to enjoy, so you present something which they consider enjoyable and advertise it. But one who has taken to devotional service should understand the principle that we live and act only in enjoyment of Krishna, not for our own personal enjoyment. Just like this song you were singing, Gora Vidita Kirtana Shri, that the kirtan should be that which is specifically for the pleasure of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this is kind of activity which we like to do for our own sense gratification, and we kind of make it slightly Krishna conscious. That is not for the body, not for initiates. Preaching we may and make some adjustment for the karma. That doesn't mean that we become like karmis ourselves. Just like some of the things you say to convince people to take books, you don't say them in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Especially the temple room, Srimad. Anywhere the body should engage, except in the temple, at least in this place. Only activities are directly Krishna conscious in the mind of Acharya. Those who have good Krishna conscious sense will appreciate it. They're straightforward, excellent. And others will make so many arguments, it's actually good. What is good and what is not good is understood in Krishna's
What should be meditation of a Sankirtan devotee during japa, and what should be his meditation during morning walk?
Krishna, all energy of Krishna, he's engaging in Ashram. Shri Prabhupada, Kijaya.